Hey gang, we're here at the Gunsite and we had the unique opportunity to have a short chat with Ken Campbell, the CEO, COO of the Gunsite Academy. Nice to meet you.
Good to be here. Good to have you here, rather.
Yeah. So what's your background? How did you end up working here?
All right. I was very fortunate. I started to work when I was 19 years old at a sheriff's office in central Indiana. And I worked my way up through the ranks there over 35 years. I was SWAT commander, I was a firearms instructor, and I ended up as 8 years as the elected sheriff. Well, during that interim period, I was blessed to have some very good sheriffs who sent us to some of the best training in the world, and Gunsite was one of those places. Jeff Cooper still ran the place then, and I came out here in 1990, and in late 1992, early 1993, I was out here for a class, and Colonel Cooper made the selections for the part-time staff then, and I was very fortunate to make that selection. So I worked part-time here for several years, and in late 2013, I was approached by Buzz Mills, who owns Gunsite, about my retirement from the sheriff's office and coming to work and being the COO at Gunsite. Now, quite frankly, I had to make sure I closed my mouth because I was in such shock of coming and managing this tremendous place where we keep good people alive. And I spoke with my wife about that, and just a little over 4 years ago, she and I came here, and I'm just blessed to work under the Raven and be here and meet people from all over the world and all walks of life.
Yeah. So what's the history of Gunsite? It has a pretty unique background.
It is. Gunsite is the oldest privately owned and operated shooting school in the world. Not in Arizona, not United States, in the world. Now, there's military and there's law enforcement that certainly have been training much longer, but we train good people, not just military, not just law enforcement. And many people think that's who our primary students are, and that's not the case. Our majority of students are, I use the term earth people. They are just normal people, from the little old lady who door greets at Walmart to those secretive organizations that we don't discuss that come here and train. So Gunsite opened in 1976 under the ownership of Jeff Cooper. And of course, Colonel Cooper's name is so well known in the shooting world and the modern technique and what he did for the training world. They opened here in 76, he and Janelle Cooper. We had two square ranges, one live fire shoot house, and it was about 162 acres. Well, over the course of these last 43 plus years, we're now 3,200 acres. We have 26 plus ranges, multiple live fire shoot houses, multiple outdoor simulators where we can shoot out to 2,400 yards. When Gunsite opened, it was called the American Pistol Institute, and that's what Colonel Cooper focused on. However, he was really more of a rifleman than he was a pistolero. So it just came natural that they added rifle classes and then carbines and shotguns and long range rifle and edged weapons and tactical medicine and vehicle defense and citizen response to active shooter, school staff response to active shooter, and church defense. So we've grown and grown in so many ways, never forgetting our core disciplines of keeping good people alive by training them in these disciplines. So it's a unique place. It's like coming to Disneyland, only for firearms training.
Yeah.
There are few places in the world that the average person can come and get the type of training that we offer here.
Yeah, kind of what we have seen so far, it is something totally different what you see in the kind of, for example, in Finland, we just don't have this type of facilities, even not the military.
Well, we love having international students come. There are some challenges with, it's called ITAR regulations here in the United States, but they're not quite as challenging as they once were. Our training director, Dave Hartman, specializes in that for us. And with military and government related folks, it's much simpler than the average folks, but there's ways we can legally do it. And of course, that's the only way we want to do it. But we can get our some of our international students back again, and that's very fortunate.
Yeah, and you have a steady flow of international private people also coming.
We do. It's increasing. Again, with the ITAR regulations are not quite what they once were, and with the current administration, we don't feel quite as under that thumb, I guess would be the best way to describe that.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing. And again, as long as the people can pass the background check, the legal term would be a proper person.
Yeah.
It's wonderful to have them here and train with them.
Yeah, that's great. Any kind of tips or lessons learned over your vast career for the people who are seeking for the training or training themselves to be a better marksman?
Certainly. Don't believe everything you're reading here on the internet. Seek good training. You know, we'd love to have you here at Gunsite without fail, and we'll offer you some of the best training in the world. However, there's also other good trainers out there. So seek that good training. Make sure you vet it properly so that the training you get is real world by people that the term Colonel Cooper used, people who have seen the elephant, people who have experienced it, worked those two-way ranges, that adds something to, I don't want to say credibility, but to your abilities in there. So make sure you seek that good training and continue to train throughout. I just took a two-day class from a friend of mine down in Phoenix a month or so ago. I work at one of the greatest shooting schools in the world, but I don't get enough trigger time.
Yeah.
So I went down there and spent some time. Again, I knew who the instructor was. I vetted that and had a great time with a couple other Gunsite instructors. So continue to train throughout your life because the bad guys do. When I was sheriff, I had a jail, and a jail or a prison is a university for bad guys. They train. If you don't think they do, you're wrong. So we need to continue training as well. So that, I guess that would be the advice that I'd offer. Continue that good training.
Yeah. Thank you very much that we were able to come here and you took the time to talk to us. It was this site has a really unique history, and it was nice to hear more about it.
Well, we're glad to have you here, your associates, and certainly hope we can attract some other folks to come here to Gunsite to get that great training. And you're welcome back at any opportunity.
We will.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Take care.